In the last video, we learned about the comparison test. We had two positive series, and throughout this video, we're going to assume that all of the ans are positive and all of the bns are positive. And we learned how to compare them. We saw that smaller is better, that if the bns converge and the ans are smaller than the bns, well, if the sum of the bns converges and the ans are smaller than the bns, the sum of the ans converges. And we saw that bigger is worse. If the sum of the BNs diverge and ANs are bigger than BN, then the sum of the ANs diverge. And the things we typically compare things to are either P series, 1 over N to the P, which we saw by the integral test that that converges if and only if P is bigger than 1, or to geometric series. We saw that geometric series converge if the ratio r is less than or equal to 1. So if you can compare something to a P series or to a geometric series, you're in good shape. Now, we're going to soup up this comparison test and come up with stronger versions of it. And the first thing is we're going to say, you know what, an doesn't really have to be less than bn. It just has to be less than a multiple of bn. So let's pick a multiple c, and we'll say if an is less than a multiple of bn, then, and the sum of the bn's converges, then the sum of the an's converges. And in fact, we don't even need it to be true for every value of n. We just need it to be true after a while. So forget about the first big N values. Throw out the first 100 values. Throw out the first 1,000 values, however many you want. But after that, if after a while the ANs are less than C times BN, and if the BNs converge, then the sum of the ANs converge. And if after a while, for all little n bigger than big N, if after a while the ANs are bigger than this multiple of BN, and the sum of the BNs diverge, then the sum of the ANs diverge. So what we've changed is we put in this factor of C, and we've talked about N. Now the factor of C really doesn't matter, because if the sum of the BNs converges, then the sum of C times BN converges. And if the sum of the BNs diverges, then the sum of C times the BNs diverge. So whether you use BN or C times BN doesn't matter. If one converges, then the other converges. And AN is less than something that converges, so we win. Or AN is bigger than something that diverges, so we lose. And the first N terms don't affect convergence at all. If you try to write this infinite series, it's the first N capital N terms, and then all the rest. See, this is just a fixed number. The rest, whether things diverge or not, is a matter of, are these sums bounded? Do these just add up more and more and more and more and more and go to infinity? If you add a constant to something that goes to infinity, it still goes to infinity. If you add a constant to something that doesn't go to infinity, it still doesn't go to infinity. This behaves just like this. So when talking about convergence, you don't care about what happens at the beginning of the series. You're really interested in what happens at the end of the series. And now we get the strongest version of all, which is called the limit comparison theorem, or the limit comparison test. Let's suppose we have two series, and the ratio of them approaches a certain constant, a certain positive constant. Then either they both converge or they both diverge. The reason is, if you take a large value of n, we said that the limit of the ratio was c. So after a while, the ratio is really close to c. In particular, the ratio is going to be bigger than c over 2, and it's going to be less than 2c. You know, an is going to be close to c times bn, so it's going to be bigger than c over 2 times bn, and less than 2c times bn. So if the bn's converge, Well, then AN is less than 2C times that, so the ANs converge. If the BNs diverge, the ANs are bigger than C over 2 times that, so the ANs diverge. And of course, when I say AN diverge, I really mean the sum of the ANs diverge. When I say the BNs converge, I mean the sum of the BNs converge. We're always talking about the convergence of a series, not the convergence of the underlying sequence. So let's look at an example. Let's look at the sum of 103 divided by n squared minus 7n plus 50. How does that behave? Well, we've got an is 103 over n squared minus 7n plus 50, and we're going to compare that to 1 over n squared. That's the thing that behaves. I mean, you kind of think that in the long run, the 7n plus 50 shouldn't matter much. The factor of 103 shouldn't matter much. So an obvious guess of what to compare it to is 1 over n squared. So we compute our limit. The limit of an over bn is the limit of 103n squared over n squared minus 7n plus 50. And we learn how to take those limits. That's sort of like the limit as x goes to infinity of 103x squared over x squared minus 7x plus 50. And we learned several ways to handle that. You can either divide the top and the bottom by x squared. Or you can use L'Hopital's rule. Either way, you're going to get the limit is 103. So 103 is a positive number. So either these both converge or they both diverge. Well, you know what the answer is. You know that the sum of 1 over n squared converges. So, the sum of this messy guy also converges by the limit comparison test.